What's up, man? Bless up.
You're going to follow this one. Okay, that's the one you're going to follow today. Okay? And then you're going to follow this elder behind you. Okay, that's the direction. Come. You're going to follow her. She knows what to do. Her DNA is already taken. So follow instructions. Okay? Now, before you go inside, this is a spiritual journey you're on. All right? So you need to get in another mode. Okay, the mode is not the one you came with. It's another mode you have to be in. She's already done that, been there, okay? She's gonna take you for a walk of going through, okay? So you're gonna be next. This is our Harlem Women International, know all about that. She's gonna be behind her, okay? Sister,
yes.
Yes.
Let's go on. All right. If there was some
now, we are going through this journey. We are going through this journey to our ancestors, and I was able to do my DNA. In 2015, after the dedication of this monument, my DNA blares me out that in respect and honor of our ancestors, that we descendants must take this journey back to the shores of Mother Africa. As we go through this, in the spirit of our ancestors, we ask God to hold us in all things and all ways. We come before the God who has been our ancestors.
Yes.
Ancestors come from the great waters of Haiti, the revolutionary struggle of a people. We come today in the spirit of our ancestors, blessing and guide them on the sacred path of life. As a son of Africa and from the shores of Haiti, the blood runs deep in the soil of our ancestors. Today, we say to you, our son, that you're on a mission beyond yourself that is a part of the African of your DNA, who you really are. Today, we're going to do your DNA. Let you swipe here. Historically, you'll be the fourth person ever came before the monument of our ancestors. The Creator allowed me to walk first as an elder. And then the Creator allowed my daughter, the hip hop generation, to walk through. She also spoke to the world community from South Korea, representing all young people from around the world, was her voice spoken here. And in the series of her work, we want her to say a few words, what it meant for her to be able to move in this energy that we're placing you in today. In witness of our women of the Harlem Women International, our interns, our young people, the world community is what this is all about. This is the world. Before you is the world that is beckoning a call for you to take up the mantle. And how that link is going to take place. You were fortunate to have met with a historical ambassador that represents all of Africa. The 50 some odd states of Mother Africa. You met him yesterday. That was in divine fitting for you for this to take place today. And so in that divine fitting for you, we call on our ancestors and the God force within you, whatever name you may call that God greater than yourself, that wakes you up in the morning and lay you down at night. Reckon within your soul energy. It's not something outside of you. Is something inside of you. So as an elder, I ask that Ruth says a couple of words, or she may do a spoken word in the presence of our ancestors and the God forth in all of us. Never have before.
As she said, I took my DNA, and before taking my DNA, I had a lot of questions. I didn't know my ancestors, even my last name, and back to the repatriation now. Now my next step is to go to Africa. Now that I know that who I am. So I just hope that the journey is, it's different for everyone from what I know and what I've seen this far. So just, I wish you just the best as far as starting the process, and that's what this is today. Even for you to be able to take it and decide that this is what you want to do, that was your choice, and that's a personal choice and a personal decision, and it's a spiritual decision if you ask me. So I just pass it on to you, and hopefully when you get your results back, it will be an awakening as it was for me.
I would like to let her ask her to see, say a few words to you in the spoken word.
I just don't have anything that came to my heart right now.
Came to your heart to speak on his behalf.
I don't.
When it comes, she speaks. When it doesn't come, it doesn't. She doesn't speak. Okay. So for whatever reason, the creator has not allowed her to speak from her rhythm, life, who she is. I'm gonna ask our sister from the Congo. I'm calling on her. I want you to come and say a few words to our warrior brother. Okay, this is one that was born on the soil of Mother Africa. You're looking at a sister who was born on the soil of Mother Africa. She is from Africa, and I'm sure she has a couple of words to say to you, of bringing you back into the continent, Mother Africa, because I see you traveling throughout Africa, unknown to yourself. So she will be the one that usher your energy back into Mother Africa. Words from you.
Welcome, brother. I'm your sister. We are really connected, but our grandma, she's my grandma. She's my mom. She's my everything. And I'm so happy to share love with you from her, because I got love, and we are sharing more love. So welcome to the big Madeleine of Africa.
And now we're going to ask, we have one more young person that we asked her to come to join you today. And we asked Sister Leslie, which is one of our women, okay? And she brought this young woman on your left, on your right side, on my left side, to me, okay? Nobody here by accident, okay? And with Mama Leslie, who nurtured children, young people, that's what she does as a spiritual mother. And we would leave our mother always in the beginning and at the end. So in that way, you are centered and hollowed and rocked in the energy you need to be as a male child. We would ask that another daughter speak that Mother Leslie brought, okay, today with her from Philadelphia. So we're gonna ask the young lady to say a few words to you in this ceremony today that means a lot to you. Yes. Come forward over here, dear beloved sister. Say a few words to him.
I first want to say to you that I'm extremely happy for you that you can find out where you come from. One thing that's very important, in order to know where you're going, you need to know where you came from. And I believe a lot of us, as the culture and as the people, because we don't know where we come from, we're so misguided. And this is the first step to becoming the man that you want to be. Eventually, I mean, if you have children, eventually you have children to pass into your children, so they can pass into their children. Because the thing is, somewhere along the way, we lost a sense of self. And though you may think it's just a DNA test, it's so much more. And I want to say to you to not take this lightly. Please don't take it lightly. Because when you find out where you come from, it's going to be a sense of relief, a sense of joy. A sense of sadness, all because you would have wished that you knew before. A sense of joy because now you do know, but also like how much of my culture do I really not know? How much was actually lost, you know, because of the spiritual. And so I just want to say to you, from my sister to my brother, that I commend you for taking this journey. And I wish you all the best in all your endeavors.
Now we have another brother from Algeria. In the energy of harmony and balance, a male speak to another male. That is how it is done in the culture. So I asked Chuke to come over and say words to you coming from North Africa.
Yes. first country in Africa. It's the first time I spent 1 year away from my country, my continent. And I live with the feeling of someone who is away from two mothers. But you know, but being born in Africa, all generations in Africa, gave my existence my existence here in the US is all about being an African, being haunted by the African cause and by empowering Africa. And that's what brought me here, that's what brought me to the UN. And I know that knowing you, who you are, knowing your origins, is going to change a lot of things in your mind, and it's going to change a lot of, it's going to change your path. So I really want to be, I want to do this DNA test. I know this is gonna be a whole new journey for you. Congrats on this.
We're gonna ask our Nigerian son that's here. Yesterday he did a radio show, which everything is like in divine order. The three of the journalists came to me yesterday and he had over 32 million Africans in Nigeria hearing my voice yesterday. But it's always about a preparation for you today. And so I'm gonna ask this warrior's son from the soil of Mother Africa, the largest group of Africans living in Africa is Nigeria. So we ask that he says a few words to you.
Thank you, Queen Mother. How you doing, my brother? Fundamentally, we own the world. The black race, the future of the world, the beginning of the world started with us. Remember the Alexandra's story that we started life started in Africa. I am proud to be black. I will ever be proud to be black till I die. Nobody can sell lies to me. Nobody can sell fallacy to me. Blacks are the best race on the surface of earth. We welcome back. We've got the strongest gene ever in the whole world. That is Africa. And I tell you this, every idea that you see on the surface of the earth started from the black race. But someone stole it away and said we originated it. You know what? We are taking over the planet. Welcome.
Now we ask that another mother to speak to you quickly. And she is from the Caribbean. She represents the CARICOM countries. And I know that your ancestors are from Haiti. And so the CARICOM sister that will say a few words is Miss Byfield from Jamaica, representing the CARICOM country.
Yes, welcome. I applaud you in taking this journey. I hope that it will become fulfilling when you actually come to the conclusion of finding out your DNA and your history and where you came from. And in the path of finding your way,
we have another daughter that came here. She's going to welcome you back home after you take your DNA back to the soil of Mother Africa. This is our son who finds his way home. And we want you to say a couple of words to him about coming home. Welcome him back to Africa.
That's your brother. That's all.
We're doing his DNA. He's coming home to Africa. Welcome him home.
Welcome, my brother. Welcome, my brother.
You know, you have one kind of sister. This is the sister that we always have to babysit.
Yes, exactly.
Let her speak.
Yes.
She got to welcome him home.
Yes.
He's from here, slavery. He's trying to get home to be with you. Okay, all right.
Come on. Let's see what's going on.
You're welcome home. It's good to have you around.
I need that.
Tell them where you from.
Oh, I'm from Nigeria.
And and what is your tribe and how you speak? What is your language? Speak to him.
Okay, so I'm from Nigeria. I'm from the western part of Nigeria. And we speak Yoruba. That's all.
So can you welcome him in Yoruba language?
Karibu in Swahili. Karibu.
Jumbo.
Karibu. Karibu.
We want the elder to close it out for us. The elder will close it out. Ruth, let the elder close this out, which is what, and now we want her to close it out with a few words to you.
My son, I am honored. I am honored through the ancestors and for the ancestors, and I am of the ancestors. For you to be here on this day to represent the art. You represent many generations in the past and many in the future. So wherever you endeavor and you go, you have many souls on your shoulders. And so we're entrusting in you for our future, for our reconstruction, because Mother Land is still our land. And so I'm giving you a vow that you are going to have to vow to the ancestors for the future and to take on the journey where they left off. So I give you my love.
And then we have one more son to speak. We asked Lewis to say a few words to you. Family also is from the Caribbean, but he's here in the U.S. Achuke, can I ask you all to really pay attention to the level of energy we're doing here spiritually around our son, okay? Let us do that. And let's let Lewis say a couple of words, please.
I would like to welcome you, brother.
Thank you, brother.
On the journey that you're taking today. It's actually a new experience for me, but I welcome you for the passage that you're taking to actually reconnect with your ancestors. I mean, there were over 50,000 African slaves that were actually killed during the triangular trade, and being that you're trying to reconnect with them, you know, to their prior history before colonialism, before slavery itself, before the segregation, is that your big honor that you're connecting with your ancestors?
Now we're going to ask Ruth to prepare you to take your DNA, and then once you take it, you would take it to the post office and drop it.
We have to go to the library first, so to activate it online.
Okay, let him
take it first. Okay. Can't mail it out without it.
Okay, you have to do that. You have to go to the library next. Can we do the DNA now? All right, let's do your DNA now. We're getting ready to do his DNA. Can we have photos of that? It's done here. He's doing his DNA right now. Come.
It's not, it doesn't take a while.
No, just look. You got to do it now. You got to do it now. You're asking God to hold you and that God would allow you to return back to the soil of your people and that you will walk around and know who you really are.
Can you hold it up? Son, hold it up.
And let him hold it here.
Yes.
Come here and hold here it up. And let him come here. Turn around, and hold it up at the arc. You're doing it at the arc.
Yes.
This is history.
Yes.
Heads of state from all over the world come to this arc.
Yes.
millions of people come here. They don't even know where they're coming, mm-hmm. but they end up here. Mm-hmm. What a place where it is at the United Nations.
Yes. Yes. Keep it right here.
Just when we did this saliva, I remember back home in Africa, each time you have to travel, my grandfather used to do that, and he put saliva, he did this movement to say like, you will never get lost. If you were lost, we just find you.
And you could do it.
I like that.
You could do it.
You just always go back.
From the ancestors she gave you, she gave you a spiritual lesson from the elders. That's what she did, okay? You never get lost again. Never get lost again.
Can we have the family gather with him now?
Okay. Everybody can come. Everybody come.
We want the family to gather around.
Come. They want to get a photo.
I have a laptop. We got Wi-Fi.
Okay. We have to do like sideways. We have to stay like sideways.
Sideways.
All of you come. One person is going to pick.
Sideways.
One person is going to pick tight.
Yeah.
Can you see us now?
Can you guess? If we do like a horseshoe.
You want me on the side?
Oh,
sideways?
This way?
This?
Okay, yeah. Sideways, everybody. Sideways.
Nice. Agaya.
I think the brother wants you to head.
Well, it's a blessing, first of all, to be here in New York and to come to the United Nations and go through the ceremony as far as getting my DNA. I know a lot about my ancestors coming from West Africa, Dahomey, and Haiti, and the Haitian Revolution. In the spirit of my ancestors, Toussaint Louverture, Jean-Jacques Dessalines, Marcus Garvey, Harriet Tubman, Queen Nzinga, it's a blessing to be here. I'm not going to allow my ancestors fight freedom or the enslavement that they went through, the torture they went through, to go in vain. But at the same note, not to let their contributions to society, their ingenuity, the creativity, to go to waste either. Thank you, Queen Mother, for doing this for me. I'm so honored and blessed.
Yes. You get a picture.
And it means a lot to me. This is a high honor.
Yes.
Probably the highest honor I've ever received in my life. So I thank you and I pray that all is well with all of you and that we continue to remember our ancestors and educate the young ones because they are the future. Thank you and many blessings. Yes.
Thank you.
And we would say
thank you,
that we want him to carry the message when he go out and do his work. Make sure that the Congressional Black Caucus knew it happened.
Yes.
Make sure that Brother Minister Farrakhan and the nation knew it happened.
Yes.
And just pass it out to all the black churches.
Yes.
You know, just put the sound out.
Yes.
Let them know. All of the black colleges know that you're doing
today.
Because you're doing it for all of them.
Very much.
Okay? Yes. Get the word to Black Wall Street today what you did.
Mm-hmm.
That they did not die in vain and creating wealth, which they had a right to do. They count because they come out of the belly of Mother Africa.
Mm-hmm.
And for you to have been able to meet with Ambassador Tete, Antoine Tete. He is the ambassador for all of Africa yesterday. You met him yesterday.
What an honor.
You met him yesterday. That's not that many would ever have met him. But it was meant for you to do so. So I would say to you, my son, stay on this sacred path and do what God has commission you to do. That go beyond your mother and your father and your sister and your brother. God has taken you from many, and you was brought to me based on that. And when I first heard your voice on the phone, there was a connection to the African burial ground which Louis is going to take you to. And also here, the Ark of Return. I am the Queen Mother of the African Burial Ground. And I name the 419, which they work children to death in the United States of America. And the ancestors allowed me to name them before their remains went back into the ground. So on that energy, I leave you as I think of the name and pray for the name that God will usher in for you. The beginning and the end of all life will protect you, lead and guide you. As I say to you, my son, stay on the sacred path of life.
Amen.